Hi everyone, welcome to MyMax Academy. In this video, we'll continue with the chapter Arithmetic Progression, which is your chapter 5 from your 10th standard CBSE Mathematics. I will continue with exercise 5.2, page number 106 in your textbook, problem number 4. Exercise 5.2, page number 106, problem number 4. What it says is, which term of this AP is 78? We have to find which term of this given AP is 78. Right, so if we keep on writing, so this is your first term, second term, third term, fourth term, like that. If we keep on writing, 78 will be which term? 78 will be which term? So which means the solution for this is, we will assume that 78 as nth term, right? So let an equal to 78. So we are assuming the nth term of the AP is 78, and we have to find it. We have to find the value of n. And what is n? Yeah, an is a plus n minus 1 into d. That is the formula for an, any nth term of an AP, and that is equal to 78. Now we should substitute the value of a and d, and we know the AP. If you know the AP, what is the value of a? A is the first term, 3. And the common difference d is a2 minus a1, which is 8 minus 3. Fine. So 8 minus 3, which is 8 minus 3, which is 5. So that is your common difference. So once we know the a and d, we can substitute in this equation and we can find the value of n. So let's substituting a is 3 and d is 5 in this. So what will become? So this is a is 3 plus n is n minus 1. We have to find n, and d is 5. That is equal to 78. So we get n minus 1 into 5 equal to 78 minus 3. So plus 3 goes this side, it becomes minus 3. So we get n minus 1 into 5. We need not multiply. If you want, we can multiply, or we can keep it as it is. Either case, it is okay. Or we can, if you want, you can multiply also. So 5 into n is 5n. 1 into minus 1 is 5 into minus 1 is minus 5 equal to 78 minus 3 is 75. So your 5n is equal to 75. This minus 5 goes here, it becomes plus 5. Right, so your 5n becomes 75 plus 5 is 80. So your n is equal to 80 by 5, which is 60. So n equal to 60, which means the 78 is the 16th term of the AP. So 78 is the 16th term of AP, which means in bracket your A16 will be equal to 78. That is the meaning of 16th term. A16 is 16th term of the AP is 78. Right? So this completes the fourth problem. We'll go to the fifth problem. Right? So what the fifth problem says? Find the number of terms in each of the following AP. Again, it's almost same as the fourth problem. The first one, the AP is given as 7, 13, 19, and so on till 205. Till 205. Now we have to find how many terms are there in this AP. This AP has how many terms? 205. 205. So how many terms are there in this AP? Fine. So again, to find the number of terms in AP, let's try to find A and D. A is the first term, 7. So always any AP is given, it's better to write what is the first term, which is A, and the common difference D, which is A2 minus A1. And A2 is 13. Minus a1 is 7, so that gives you 6. Fine. So your a is 7 and your common difference d is 6. Now we have to find how many terms are there. This is first term, second term, third term, like that. This is which term? So if you don't know this is which term, we'll assume this as the nth term. So we'll say let an equal to 205. From this we have to find n. From this we have to find n, right? So that will give the number of terms in the AP. So how many terms are there? Which means you have to find n. This is first term, second, third, like that. This is which term? So that will give the total number of terms. Right? How many terms are there in the AP means, if it is the 10th term, then there are 10 terms in the AP. If this is 20th term, then there are 20 terms in AP. Right? So we will find n here. So an is what? A plus n minus 1 times d equal to 205. And a is 7, so 7 plus n minus 1 into d, d is 6 equal to 205. Now that becomes 7 plus 6 into n is 6n, 6 ones are 6 equal to 205, right? Then 7 minus 6 is 1, 7 minus 6 is 1, so it becomes 6x plus 1 equal to 205. So your 6n equal to 205 minus 1, your 6n is 204. With this plus 1 comes this side, it becomes minus 1, here 7 minus 6 is 1. And that 1 goes to the right hand side, so it becomes 204. So n is equal to 204 by 6. So if you cancel, you get 3 times and this is 4 times. So n is equal to 34, which means there are 34 terms in this AP. So you'll say this is first problem, right? There are 34 terms in the AP, in the given AP. So that AP arithmetic progression, this arithmetic progression, it has 34 terms because this is the 34th term. That is the 34th term. Now the second part of fifth question, which is fifth question, second part. So again, we have to, there is an AP that is given, which is 18, 15, 1 by 2. So the AP is 18, comma 15, 1 by 2, comma 13, comma dot 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 minus 47. Right. So again, we have to see how many terms are there in this AP. We have to find n. Same as this problem. So we'll first find what is A, the first term. First term is 18. Right. Solution. And your common difference D is A2 minus A1. And A2 is 15 1 by 2. So 15 1 by 2 minus 18. So 15 1 by 2 is 31 by 2. Converting the mixed fraction to improper fraction minus 18, then it will become 31 minus 36 by 2. If you take the LCM and do it, you get minus 5 by 2. So that is your D. Your D is minus 5 by 2. Now, let's assume this as AN. We'll assume this minus 47 as AN. So AN equal to minus 47. Now we have to find N. Right? So AN formula is what? A plus N minus 1 into D. That is equal to minus 47. So we are taking this as the nth term. So this is a1, a2, a3, dot 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 dot. This is an. And if we know what is n, then we'll know how many terms are there in this AP. Then we'll know how many terms are there in this AP. So now a is 18 plus n minus 1 times d. D is minus 5 by 2. So you have to be careful when negative comes, equal to minus 47. Now this 18 goes to the other side. It becomes minus 18, n minus 1 times minus 5 by 2 equal to minus 47 minus 18. This plus 18 goes to the right side, becomes minus 18. Now I can write this as minus 5 by 2 of n minus 1 also. I can write this minus 5 by 2 in the front. Then this is minus 15, 65. Fine. So again, what we can do, so our n minus 1 will become minus 65 into this minus 5 by 2 will become 2 by minus 5. When it goes to the other side. So minus 5 by 2, if it goes to the right hand side, it will become 2 by minus 5. So 5 and this one will get cancelled. You get 13. Then minus minus also gets cancelled. 2 times 13 is 26. 2 times 13 is 26. So therefore, your n is equal to 27. 26 plus 1. So n is equal to 27. So how many terms are there? There are 27 terms there in this AP. So there are 27 terms in the given AP. Fine. So this completes your fifth problem, 27. Fine. All of you can pause the video and take the notes. Let's do the next problem, which is sixth one. The sixth problem says, sixth question, it says, check whether minus 150 is a term of the AP. So AP is given. AP is 11, 8, 5, then 2, dot, 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 dot. So this is the AP. They have given that it's an AP. We have to check whether minus 150 is a term of this AP. So check is minus 150. Is minus 150 is a term of this AP. That is the question. We have to check whether minus 50 will come. If we keep on writing down the line, do we get minus 50 here? And this is the AP that is given, right? Solution. We have to check whether minus 150 is a term of this AP. So we will assume that nth term is minus 150. Let's say let an equal to minus 150. Then let's try to find what is n. If n is a positive integer, then minus 150 will be one of the terms of this AP. If n is not a positive integer, then we will say minus 150 is not a term of this AP. If I assume that sum for some n, it is equal to minus 150, and we know n. N denotes the number of terms, and number of terms cannot be negative or even zero or fraction. It should be a positive integer. Your n should be always a positive integer, which means it can be 1, 2, 3, or you can say n is a natural number. N is a natural number. Now, what is the AN formula? A plus n minus 1 into d. That is equal to minus 150. Now, let's find what is A, what is d first. So, what is A? So, here A is the first term, 11, and comma d is A2 minus A1, and A2 is 8 minus A1 is 11. So, 8 minus 11 is minus 3. So, our first term is 11. Our common difference is minus 3. Now, let's find, let's substitute here to find the value of n. So, A is 11 plus n minus 1. N is what we are going to find. So, I am not substituting any value for n. And D is minus 3. That is equal to minus 150. So, I can write this as 11 goes this side. So, it becomes n minus 1 times minus 3 equal to minus 150 minus 11. Fine. The 11 goes this side. So, now if you multiply this, minus 3 into n is minus 3n. Minus 3 into minus 1 is plus 3. So, it becomes minus 161. So, minus 150 minus 11 is minus 161. Now, minus 3n will become minus 161 minus 3. So, this plus 3 goes this side, becomes minus 3. So, you get minus 164. That is minus 3n. So, your n becomes minus 164 by minus 3. Fine. And that becomes, that makes your n as n becomes 164 by 3. So, it doesn't go in 3 because 6, 1 plus 6 is 7, 7 plus 4 is 11. So, sum of the digits is not divisible by 3. So, therefore, this number is not divisible by 3. Therefore, n is a fraction. Now, the moment n is a fraction, it's not a positive integer. Therefore, n is not a positive integer. Therefore, minus 150 cannot be a term of the AP. Cannot be a term of the given AP. So, minus 150 can never be a term. Right? Cannot be a term of an AP. So, that is how we do the sixth problem. Now, let's go to the seventh problem. So, seventh problem is, so what is given? So, given is, find the 31st term of an AP. So, which means we have to find the 31st term. 31st term means A31 equal to question mark. 31st term means A31. Find the 31st term of an AP whose 11th term is 38. 11th term means A11. A11 is 38. And 16th term is 73. A16 equal to 73. Let us find the 31st term of the AP, where whose 11th term is 38, which means A11 is 38, and the 16th term is 73. A16 is 73, and we should find what is A31. Let us find what is A31, 31st term of the AP. Now, when they show solution, what is A31? A31 is A plus 31 minus 1 into D. Now we are applying the formula AN equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Right? A suffix N is A plus n minus 1 into d. So a 31 is a plus 31 minus 1 into d. Now here if you find a and d and if you substitute, so that is same as a plus 30d. Your a 31 is a plus 30d. So once we find a and d, we can substitute in this and we can find the 31st term. So we need to know what is a, what is d. In all the problem of AP or most of the problems, we need to know a and d. If you know a and d, then we will be able to find anything of that AP. So now A11 is given as 38. So A11 is 38. What does it mean? It means that A plus 11 minus 1 into D is 38. See, we need to know A and D. We need to find two variables, A and D. Whenever we want to find two variables, we need to get two equations involving those two variables. Once we have two variables with A and D, then we can solve those two. I mean, once we have two equations with those two variables, A and D, then we can solve that and find the value of A and D. So we are trying to get two equations having A and D. So this will give you the one first equation, this will give you second equation. So A11 is 38, which means A plus 11 minus 1 into D, which means A plus 10D equal to 38. A plus 10D equal to 38. So here A16 is equal to 73. So this is equation 1. A16 means A plus 16 minus 1 into D equal to 73, which means A plus 15D equal to 73, which is 2, equation 2. Fine. Now we will have to solve A and D. We have to solve these two equations and find the value of A and D. So I am writing the equations again. A plus 10D equal to 38, that is equation number 1. Then A plus 15D equal to 73, that is equation 2. Now we have to solve these two equations and find the value of A and D. Now we'll subtract, we'll go by elimination method. So change the signs, then this becomes minus 5D is equal to 5 and 6 minus 3 is 3, so minus 35. So you get D equal to minus 35 by minus 5, but D is equal to plus 7. Now we have found D, let's substitute the value of D in one of the equations to find A. So we have A plus 10D equal to 38 and A is, we don't know, plus 10 into D is 7. Substitute 7 here. So D into 7 equal to 38. Fine. So A plus 10 times 7 is 70 equal to 38. Your A becomes 38 minus 70. So your A becomes minus 32. Right. Your A is minus 32. Right. So now we have found A, we have found D. Now we should substitute in this A31. So what is A31? So I am writing here. So A31 equal to A plus 30D. We have to find A31 only, which means the 31st term. So let's substitute here. So what do we get? 7. So that is equal to minus 32 plus 30 times D. D is 7. So that is equal to minus 32 plus 210. Right? So that will be how much? 210 minus 32 is 8. 10 means 7, 178. So your A31 is 178. Fine. So the 31st term of the AP is 178. That is the 31st term of the AP. Right? So the 31st term. We will say 31st term is 178. That is the answer. So all of you can pause the video and take the notes. I will go to the next problem, which is problem number 8. Where is this? Fine. So 8th problem is, what is given? An AP consists of 15 terms of which AP consists of 50 terms of which third term is 12 and last term is 106. Find the 29th term. Find the 29th term. So what we should say, so what is given is, AP has 50 terms. AP has 50 terms and the third term is 12, which means A3 is 12 and the last term is 106. Last term is 106. Last term is 106, but the AP has 50 terms, which means the last term is 50th term. So, which means A50 equal to 106. Right? The last term is 106. So, AP has 50 terms. Third term is 12 and the last term is 106 means what? What is the last term? It has totally 50 terms. Which means the last term will be A50. Right? If the AP is like this, A1, A2, A3, dot, 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 dot. If it has 50 terms, means it is A50. And they said the third term is 12 and the last term is 106, which means A50 is 106. Right? Now, what we should find? We should find the 29th term. So, we have to find A29th. That is question mark. Which is the 29th term of the AP, which is exactly similar to the same thing. We have to solve, we have to take these two, get the value of A and D. After finding the value of A and D, we have to substitute in this to find A29. So, solution is, now A29 we have to find, which is the 29th term of the AP. We have to find the 29th term of the AP, that is A29. So, A29 is what? A plus 29 minus 1 into D, as per that formula, An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. In the place of N, I am putting 29. So, it becomes A plus 28D. That is your A29. Right? Now, to find A29, we should know what is A, what is D. If we know what is A, what is D, we can substitute here and we can find the value of A29, which is the 29th term of the AP. Now, to find A and D, we have to go to these two given information. So, A3 is 12. So, A3 is given as 12, which means A plus 3 minus 1 into D, that is A3. A3 is A plus 3 minus 1 into D is 12 equal to, which means A plus 2D is equal to 12. This is your first equation. Now, let's take A50 is 106. So, A50 is 106. Fine. A50 is 106. So, A50 is A plus 50 minus 1 into D. That is equal to 106. Fine. So, A plus 49D equal to 106. Now, this is your second equation. Now, we should solve the first equation and the second equation to find the value of A and D, and we can use our elimination method, which we studied in chapter 3, which is pair of linear equations in two variables. So, I am writing the first equation, which is A plus 2D is equal to 12, and the second equation is A plus 49D equal to 106, second equation. So, we have to solve this and find the value of A and D. Now, we will subtract minus, minus, they get cancelled. Now, 49 minus 2 is minus 47D. Equal to, now if you subtract these two, we get 4 and 9 and minus 94. Minus 94. So D becomes minus 94 by minus 47, which means D is 2. Because 47 times 2 is 94. So your D is 2. Common difference is 2. Now we need to find A. Now how do we find A? We'll substitute the value of A in one of the equations. So, A is, we will take the first, this equation, A plus 2D equal to 12, which means A plus 2 into D, D is 2. Common difference is 2, that is equal to 12. So, if you want, I will write it here, D is equal to 2, fine. D is equal to 2 and we have to, so D equal to 2. So, if you substitute here, we get, if you substitute D is equal to 2 here, we get A plus 4 equal to 12, that gives you A equal to 12 minus 4, you get A is equal to 8. So, what we have got? We have got D as 2 and A is 8. Now, we will substitute that in our this one, A29. So, what is A29? A29 is A plus 28D. So, A is 8 plus 28 times D, D is 2. That is 8 plus 28 times 2 is 56, which gives you 64. So, your 29th term of the AP is 64. Fine. So, that is the 29th term of the AP. And we are supposed to find the 29th term. So, the 29th term is 64. So, 29th term of the AP is 64. Fine. So, this completes your 8th problem. Now, let's go to the 9th one. So, 9th problem is ninth question. Yes. If the third and ninth term of the AP are 4 and minus 8 respectively, which term of this AP is 0? Important question. Right? This is important. So they said third term and ninth term of the AP are 4 and minus 8 respectively, which means third term is 4, which means A3 is equal to 4, and the ninth term is minus 8. A9 equal to minus 8. That is the ninth term. Right? So third term is 4. Ninth term is minus 8, then which term of the AP is 0? So which term is 0? Which term will be 0? Right? So we should find which term of this AP is 0. So which means we will assume the nth term as 0. If we don't know which term is 0, we have to assume that as nth term. So, solution, let an equal to 0, which means the nth term is 0. We have to find what is n. Let's assume that which term is 0 in the AP. So, the AP is not given. But what is given? The third term of the AP is 4, the ninth term is minus 8. Those two informations are given. And they are asking whether 0 will be one of the terms of that AP. One of the terms of the AP. Now, if you don't know which term is AP, which term is 0, if you don't know which term is 0, then we'll assume an equal to 0, right? Let an equal to 0, which means a plus n minus 1 into d equal to 0. And our aim is to find the value of n, right? If you find the value of n, then we'll know which term will be 0 in that AP. To find n, we should know a and d. If you know a and d, we can substitute here and then we can find n from this equation. But we don't know A and D. To find A and D, we have to use these two information to find A and D. Also, the AP is not given. The list of numbers which form an AP, that is not given. So, if the list of numbers are given, you can immediately find the first term and the common difference by using A2 minus A1. But here it is not given. So, we will take these two equations, we will solve and find the value of A and B. Once we get the value of A and B, we will substitute here and we will get the value of N. That's why we are going to solve this problem. Now, A3 is 4. A3 is given as 4 and A3 is A plus 3 minus 1 into D, that is equal to 4, A plus N minus 1 into D formula. So, you get A plus 2D equal to 4, this is your first equation. Similarly, A9 is minus 8, which means A plus 9 minus 1 into D is minus 8, which means A plus 8D equal to minus 8. So, this is your second equation. Now, we have got two equations, which is A plus 2D is equal to 4 and A plus 8D is equal to minus 8. Let's solve both the equations and find the value of A and D. So, our first equation is A plus 2D is equal to 4, A plus 8D equal to minus 8. Now, let's change the sign. So, this is minus, this becomes minus, minus becomes plus, gone, minus 6D equal to 8 plus 4 is 12. So, you get 8D is equal to minus 12 by minus 6. Which means that is equal to minus 2. So, our D is minus 2. Right? The common difference is minus 2. Now, we should find the value of A. Now, substitute this in one of the equations. So, A plus 2D equal to 4, which means A plus 2 into minus 2 equal to 4, because D is 2. I am substituting D as 2. Then, it becomes A minus 4 equal to 4, which means A is equal to 4 plus 4, which means A is equal to 8. So, we got the first term A is 8 and D is 2. Now, let's substitute these. So, D is 2. So, this one and this one will substitute in this equation. Now, what we have? We have A n is 0, which means we have this equation, which is A plus n minus 1 into D is equal to 0. Because which term is 0 means we assumed nth term is 0. We assumed nth term is 0, which means A plus n minus 1 into D is 0. Then we are trying to solve and find the value of n. So, n minus 1 into d is 0. Now, a is 8 plus n minus 1 into d. D is minus 2 equal to 0. So, now 8 can go to this side. So, then it will be, so n minus 1 into minus 2 equal to minus 8, because 8 goes this side. It becomes 0 minus 8, which is minus 8. Right? So, now multiply minus 2 into n is minus 2n. Minus 2 into minus 1 is plus 2 equal to minus 8. So, your minus 2 n is equal to minus 8 minus 2. this plus 2 goes this side, it becomes minus 2. So minus 2n equal to minus 10. So your n becomes minus 10 by minus 2. Your n becomes 5. Which means the fifth term of this AP is 0. Right? So which means, which term is 0? The fifth term, n we got it as 5. Which means, I'll write here, which means A5 equal to 0. Now we have got n. So an is 0 and n is 5. Which means AF is 0. Therefore, fifth term is 0. Fifth term is 0. We are asking which term is 0. Fifth term is 0. Fifth term of the AP is 0. Fine. So all of you can pause the video and take the notes. I will stop the video here. You can watch my next video for the continuation of this. Thank you for watching. See you all in the next video. Thank you.